Hello, it's me, Voda. YouTube has a problem. Much like any degenerated third world country, masses of people are left wandering the streets, scavenging for any sort of sustenance to keep them alive. Whilst the dirty plebeian class of new uploaders struggle to obtain even the smallest morsel of viewership, the wealthy 1% consume the entirety of the platform's user base with low-effort, pre-recorded content that is pumped out daily for the drooling, gluttonous retards that comprise 99.9% of YouTube accounts. So what exactly are we, the people, supposed to do about it? Well, fortunately for you, I have compiled a few options that could prove invaluable to someone beginning the slog through the nine circles of hell. Sell your soul. If you choose to go down this path, just remember, there is absolutely no turning back. To become noticeable on YouTube, you must become a literal slave to your own content. Choose something you're okay at, like fishing or video games, and only upload that content for the rest of your life. Congratulations! In 3 to 5 years, you'll probably only need to work 2 part-time jobs in order to subsidize your lifestyle. Selling your soul is a surefire way to build reputation and gather a large following. Take NoahJ456, for example, a following of 4.27 million subscribers and growing. All he had to do was upload Call of Duty videos for 5 years straight while sprinkling in shittier FPS games occasionally. I can't think of something I'd rather do more. Undiagnosed mental illness aside, I would not recommend this strategy unless you are truly at your wit's end. Clickbait. For the snake oil merchants and shekel goblins, this is going to be a very appealing strategy for you to use. The premise is simple: create steaming piles of shit labeled content, and provide thumbnails and titles that are completely unrelated to your said pile of shit. This has been used to great acclaim in past years, and has been seeing even more success in our current year of the Lord, 2020. But perhaps you don't want to be a total troglodyte and retain some semblance of integrity on your channel. In that case, I would suggest using mildly intriguing titles that make your videos sound much more interesting than they actually are. Abuse the robot. It would be unwise to use this strategy considering that in a few years, the Hivemind supercomputer network at YouTube will have likely created its own totalitarian dictatorship over the human race, where all persons are required by law to make daily uploads about travel vlogs they created over 2 years ago. If you're still brave enough to consider this strategy, all you need to do is create videos that you're not even the slightest bit interested in, that pertain to topical content happening online. You may consider taking your own life after extended periods of uploading garbage to the platform, but hey, it's free real estate. Make good content. I think we can skip this one, as I'm sure you are also well aware of your inability to produce meaningful content. Get lucky. Some people say that luck has everything to do with success, and to those people I say, okay, retard. The premise of luck on YouTube is convoluted at best, and perhaps you may get lucky with how the robots promote your content. But at the end of the day, we live under the mentally oppressive thumb of capitalism, and if there isn't a demand for your content, perhaps you should go back to the drawing board. Such is the harsh reality of being a YouTuber, and I wish you nothing but the best. With these tips and tricks, you should be able to succeed and conquer the platform for yourself. Just look at me, a shining example of financial success on the platform. Still not convinced that I am legitimate? Well, unfortunately, there is absolutely nobody else on this platform, other than VidIQ, who can provide you with any sort of detailed analysis of the YouTube structure and algorithm. Perhaps you could go watch Brian G. Johnson TV and literally be brainwashed into following a rabbit hole of meaningless videos. Rehash the same points and topics over and over again until you have 100,000 subscribers. Very well-educated content indeed. whilst at the same time directly manipulating your audience into doing whatever you ask them to and clicking any link you might put in front of them. So perhaps the question is not how to become a YouTuber, but if you actually want to become a YouTuber at all. And I can answer that question with a simple, please do not pursue this career unless you have fucking absolutely nothing else going for you in your life. Anyways, subscribe to my channel and like the video, or you'll be seeing me tonight, roughly around 3 a.m. I hope you remembered to lock your door this time. Anyways, that's it for me, and I will see you in the next one. Bye for now.